part of Adventures in Claret and Blue. We are currently on a coach at 6:54 on a Sunday morning. As you can tell, we're very sleepy.
Yep, 6.
We're not from 6, so it's not too bad, comparatively. Yeah, nice side either. So we're going down to Chelsea today, going down to King's Meadow. Have you been to King's Meadow before?
No.
Yeah, we're
so there's a first for
somewhere.
Kate, going to King's Meadow. I've been a couple of times, including missing Mother's Day in order to go to Chelsea away. Luckily, I have a very understanding mother.
And luckily it's United this year.
Yes, luckily it's Manchester United away this year, so me and Mum can go get beaten up together. Another first is I am debuting my Alicia Lehman home shirt because I was waiting for so long to get a ridiculous photo with Anna. I'll do my goalkeeper shirt for most of the beginning of this year. But
long sleeves, probably sensible.
It was, but that goal was achieved last home game, so rocking the Christmas present from the parents and debuting my Lehman shirt. So, yes, June at London about 11. We're no doubt going to sleep on the coach, but if anything interesting happens, we'll be sure to update you. Alright, guys, so we are halfway ish. We're at the toll, so we're at the toll ish. We're currently on our rest break. This is a perk of going National Express, they tend to stop. I have bought the largest coffee that I could possibly find with an extra shop because I've not managed to sleep on the coach, whereas Madame here has. We're enjoying a lovely Mackey's breakfast, and so far it's in a good away day.
We're 2 hours into it.
Hey, I'm taking the positives where I can because we're playing Chelsea today, so.
2 hash browns.
Yeah.
The positives.
The positive is a 2 hash brown bagel and genuinely, see, I'm filming, so you can't actually see the largest coffee. Get Kate to bring it over.
It's like bigger than your head.
Yeah, that's what I'm going with. All good. We're making plans at the moment to meet up with the Pride of Irons, which will be a lot of fun. And also my co-host on We Are the Girls, Reese, should be there. It's his first away day in a long time, because he's been getting a lot of grief from a lot of us for not making the effort. We just say he doesn't like the cold.
I mean, fair, it's cold. I haven't taken my coat off yet.
No, she hasn't. I'm living dangerously with ketchup on my new shirt. So yeah, we have to be back on the bus in like a couple of minutes, so this is me signing off for now, but we will give you an update once we hit the big smoke. Hi guys, we have made it to London, if you can't tell by our usual map that is behind us. We are very, very warm in that coach.
Very warm. It was freezing when we got on it for the first like hour and a half, and then we stopped at the services.
Yep.
And then we got back on it, they switched the heating on, and it was on hot. Also, someone pulled out a puppy.
Like the tiniest dog you've ever seen.
Little Pomeranian or something.
Yeah.
Like a little teddy bear.
It was adorable. It was quite funny because there was the lady in front of us was talking about this dog to her friend and was
like, they don't have a dog.
No, they were going, oh, it's on my lap now. We were, to be honest, we were pulling faces because we were like,
there's no dog there.
There's no dog. And then I was listening to my music and then literally Kate was like, I was like, what? There's a dog. There's actually a dog.
Actual tiny teddy bear.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's literally the smallest dog I've ever seen. It was adorable.
Yeah.
And you would not have known it was there because it didn't make any noise.
No noise.
Yeah. Slept for most of the way. So that's the random things that happen when we go a travelling. Well, we're now off to go get some scran, which is my favourite northern word. Off to get some scran, and then we are going to head down to Wimbledon where we're going to meet up with some Pride Irons people. Reese is reliably on his way, he is on the district line. We hope. But we're also going to have the added bonus of Rich, who is a fellow writer on Since 71 and is also a Bristol City fan, because unfortunately their game has been postponed due to a bad pitch.
Lots of that today.
Lots of that day, because also Birmingham and Liverpool have been postponed because of that. I'm not surprised about the Bristol game, to be honest, because the Hive pitch wasn't fantastic when we played them. So, because that's what happens when you have three teams play on the same pitch, to be honest. So, yeah, so it's going to be good that Rich and his son Harvey is going to be joining us to...
Right. My arm's giving out. You've got much more to say.
I'm done. Just
yammering
right.
on.
I'm just yammering on. Right, I'm done now. So, we'll see you when we get to Wimbledon.
Normally, it's much easier to get to Wimbledon. Normally, it's much easier to get to Wimbledon. That all lines out, and that makes everything so much harder.
My mum's friend.
So, and Stephen Steinberg will appear because
he's
going to
go her mother died and had no like that generation of people that like
one of their kids lived in Stockholm and they go there.
Come on!
especially for something you.
I said, tell it!
Exactly.
Come on!
My
voice is going to be
angry.
Yeah. That's it, come on!
Yeah.